go, ladies and gentlemen. Round one. It's the grand finals here in Leipzig.
Big on home soil, looking to do the unthinkable. Not many people would have gave them a chance at even getting to the grand finals, but here they stand after taking down Heroic. Flip side, starting on the T side. And Big, initially, Kiev maybe thought about peeking through, decides better of that decision, and standard CT setup.
Yeah, he's still kind of keeping his eye on B lobby here just to see if he can get any information. Meanwhile, Leggy keeping his eyes on middle. Kiev is now starting to dance around here, throw a couple of bullets down, but he's going to back up. He's not going to give a free pick. The flip side is Electronic has full mid control, even spots one in the A bomb site. And this definitely looks like they want to split B. They have a player in Vince. They still have some presence, though. They still could bounce out of this, but here comes the commitment. Smokes in, and here comes the execute.
Kiev isolated at the back of the site. Can he pick up the USP and pull off as he's been doing with the orb all day long? No, just the one frag. That could be enough, though, to stave off the push. But here comes Waylander with two of his own onto Nex and Legia. And Thompson and God B trying to rummage together a retake. Bombs doesn't been planted, but will be momentarily. There we go. And Thompson and God B don't have any utility. They don't have a kit. This should be Flipside getting the first round on the board in the grand finals.
He'd imagine so. I mean, it might even be worth just holding on to this armor. But there is a kit right there, so maybe they could get some nice shots here. Oh my goodness, here we go. Tabson and Gabi chiming in. There's only two terrorists left. They're working into the site. Electronic trying his damnedest to hold on, but he's going to get caught by Tabson. That was only one player left. It's Markolov. The defuse will be started. Can Markolov get him off of it? He's taking so much damage. Meanwhile, Gabi stays on the defuse and Big steal the round away. What a way to start it off here from the boys at Big.
Should have been around to flip side.
Indeed.
Wasn't. Unbelievable retake frags. And again, Tabson shows why he's a boss in these pistols. Jeez, what a way to kick things off. Three kills for Tabson. Like the God B was ducking and diving as well, just on the off chance that Tabson died. It'll make him a lot harder to hit in the head, of course, with that one tap. Flip side, in the meanwhile, haven't fully committed into this round, interesting, as a result of that bomb plant. They can get AKs into the next round. So a few deagles, not much else. No nades. And looking to just force their aggression through onto B. God B is having none of it. It is pretty much a split push onto B with the rest of the team around the mid area. Well, that it has connected a one tap, which is going to keep things interesting. This isn't quite the formality maybe you're expecting when you saw the weaponry going through into this round.
Yeah, those deagles can always be dangerous, especially in the hands of guys like Electronic and World Editor, who are the two biggest playmakers on this flip side lineup. Electronic looking to see if maybe he can find an opening at A. The bomb is here as well, so it seems like this is where they want to head, but there's still some time left. We know how slow-paced Flipside usually can be, so I'm sure they'll take their time with this. Still no commitment just yet, but now Blade is caught, and the bomb's down. Now they have no choice.
That's a rough place to drop the bomb. Not that we're expecting Flipside to necessarily all charge through together as two players still in mid. But this puts a lot more pressure on Electronic to try and get a one-tap on his approach to the site. World Edit, who got the first kill for Flipside in this round, and the only kill, it should be mentioned, peering up and spots Kiev, but not fast enough to connect the shot. Markolov with a tasty UMP headshot onto Kiev, however, keeps the one-man deficit in check. 25 seconds left. Electronic's next to fall, leaving Markolov and his UMP all that remains. Down he goes, Big 2-0.
As you noted, though, there wasn't a big commitment there from Flipside. I think it was because they were hoping maybe they could get a bomb plant that round, then maybe they could do like an earlier AK buy in the third, but now that's not really an option. There's the dab.
So this is as a result of the bomb plant. Full AK-47s, three smokes and a Molotov. More than enough to play off the Flipside, and of course Blade be pulling the strings behind the team. Would appear that we could be seeing
that didn't put it out.
That's a bit awkward. You actually heard the extinguish, though, as well. Yes. Was that two incendiaries up on the boost? The extinguished one, but not the other one?
Or that, or maybe the smoke just landed too far on the edge and only got part of it down. I'm not really sure what happened there, but it didn't really matter. They still do get boosted up here in the end, as well, that it's certainly scoping things out. Waylander, seeing if he can peek into the A-bomb site here, but not finding anything just yet. Interesting to see him in this position. Normally, Electronic's going to be the guy working over on this B side, so a little bit of a personnel change for Flipside on how they're working the map.
Electronic in a duel to the death with Legia in mid on highway boxes. By himself, as his teammate just behind is smoked off, but we'll let it up on the boost. Playing patiently, waiting for those smokes and mollies previously to just dissipate. try and help out his team. Flipside haven't really got a great deal, though, so far on the board. Still two smokes in the back pocket for utility, going through later on into the round. But the bomb is moving to the B site.
Yeah, I mean, it's classic Flipside, taking it slow, getting mid-control, playing default, but now they've made their choice. They're gathering up here at B. Mid-flank is even falling back. Electronic looking to get into Vince and help commit. Can Big hold off this execute?
Got B with a perfect flashbang timing. Allows him to jump up on top of the box and get the free frag onto Wayland. They can't get any more. No, it's asking a lot with the UMP. And 25 bullets in the magazine quickly dwindled down to zero. Tapson and Keeve with yet another retake on the cards. Big pulled it off in the pistol. A very different scenario, though, against four AKs. And although Keeve has been sensational this tournament, he's not quite confident enough to try this one out. It will be Flipside getting their first round on the board. The question is, can Keeve hold on to his AWP?
Yeah, that's the only goal here, to try to carry this over into the next round, give them more to work with, able to take down Electronic, but now the rest of the terrorists know where he is and they can maybe even begin to gather up and push him down. We're all dead at just waiting it out a little bit here. And Keeve lands the shot, so he is safe. No one else in the area to threaten, and so the op will carry over.
Keeve has some sick reaction speed.
Yeah, he's definitely one of those guys that have like really cool firing speed. When you think of guys like maybe Henny, for example, is certainly someone that comes to mind as well that has that really fast firing speed. He's right up there with them.
It's mainly this shot, because he wasn't entirely sure as to which side of the opening a player would be aggressing him from, so nicely done. He's one of those players, as we mentioned in the build-up, that seems to not shy away from the spotlight, not shy away from the big moments. He is...
Or the camera.
Or the camera, indeed. Very confident guy. Very charismatic.
And I think that helps because the core of this team, and Gabi as a caller, even when he was with Energy, he really liked to structure his team around a key op. Like, he really kind of built his team around that. And you have a guy like Nex, who's more of a passive force with the rifle. So being that offset, having a guy like Keeve who can be assertive is certainly beneficial. As again, Flipside, just this classic stuff from them. I mean, you're going to see this most rounds, just trying to take it slow. At times, you'll see them take mid-control, but most of the time, they're just spreading the map, and they're looking for openings. And Keeve, he's looking to see if he can't find a pick, though. Waylander is going to be over here on the sunroom. So far, no one really taking the angle just yet. Going to be a little bit of a jump peek here from Gabi. Waylander going to spot this. And Keeve is going to take him down as he tries to escape.
So intelligent, though. Gabi goes scouting. He will spot Waylander. But he will go down afterwards to Blade. Played with the aggression through vents. Did take quite a bit of damage. Two-thirds of his health has been disintegrated. Still stands tall, though. 35 seconds left on the timer, and Big have to try and repel the onslaught onto the A side. They're about to have some more reinforcements show up on the car, so it's going to be a 3-on-4 over on this side of the map, with Tabson able to rotate quickly once that call comes through. Electronic and Nex are going to be exchanging frags. Double kill with a 5-7 for Nex on the site. Nicely played, but the damage may still be forthcoming onto Big, as Markolov is going to use the close angle, takes down a star player of Keeve, leaving Tabson, the other star, with it all to do by his lone. He's going to be pushing aggressively onto Quad. Lands the first one. Oh! Flicks onto Blade and destroys him!
And that's the Tabson you love to see. Maybe people say that Nex has a super high skills thing and Keeve's been impressive, but Tabson for me is the rock of this team. He's the consistent player. He's the one who was the big name back when they were Energy, the one that was putting up the numbers. He's definitely been a fun player to follow, and this was a big-time clutch from him. Especially considering the type of crossfire he walked into. I mean, Quad and Forklift is a difficult crossfire to break open, but you can see the timings of the peak there. Blade didn't really peek off of Markolov as well as he maybe should have, so I think Tabson got kind of that extra second to be able to 180 around. But nonetheless, it's still a sick shot. That means that Big is going to extend their lead a bit, and Flipside now have to do more with less. Just a few Tech Nines and a P250 in play. They have a couple of AKs on Waylander and World Edit, and this time they're going to kind of get away from their default. It's like they want to maybe change the pace, do something a little bit quicker. They do have Waylander still drifting towards B, but you can definitely see everyone else beginning to gather up over towards that A lobby.
And even in slow motion, that flick onto Forklift looked lightning fast. Effortless for Tabson in the end, it would seem.
Especially since that thing just eats bullets most of the time. It can be difficult to fit shots around it.
I don't think that you can overshadow how important those two 5-7 kills were for Nex as well through the smoke, but that's in the past. time to focus on the here and now. And that will see Flipside in round 5 trying to execute onto the A site. At least that's what they're trying to fake. There's a lot of utility been expended onto A. It's going to keep both Tabson and his right-hand man of Legia interested. God, B up in such a good position with the UMP. He's going to get the one kill. It's one of those scenarios, if he has the M4, you're expecting him to get 2 or 3 kills from there. But at least the information has been gathered in enough time to allow Keeve to get into heaven. Bomb still planted, an AK-47 trades hands into Markolov. But you would still feel like Big will be favorites to retake the site from this situation here. Tabson round the back. Markolov could be a dead man. This trade was very important and it's gone against the Germans. Tabson's going to be gutted with that outcome, but Keeve drops down, connects the shot. Legia comes in for one. Markolov, who was the man that Tabson could have killed, comes up with 2 more frags and secures it for Flipside, and he loves it.
And that's kind of the risk that Gabi takes by having such a forward position on B. I mean, you have a numbers advantage, and the B attack's coming in, and Gabi's the only defense left at B. He's all the way in Sunroom. You know, when he goes down with only one frag, there's no one else from Big in the area, really. So the bomb goes down safely, and that B bomb site can sometimes be hard to retake, especially given that Big didn't really have any utilities. He didn't really have them, the incendiaries or the smokes to block things off. So this relied on raw aim, and you can see Flipside rose to the occasion. And so now, Big, just on some upgraded pistols, there is one SMG here on to next. Keeve looking to get aggressive with this Deagle. He is going to be able to get out. This means that they get some information, so maybe they could cheat a little bit of a stack towards the A bomb site or middle. That is the option, but they do just kind of back down and just get a little bit more default on their CT setup.
Big did make similar buys on Dust2 Effective earlier today. So don't put this past them just yet. CZ seems to be the order of the day for 3 of the players. Deagle, and the MP9 in the hands of Keeve next. Waylander's going to be peering out of mid. Once again, it's typical Flipside. Nothing yep. too flashy, nothing too aggressive. Just solid meat and potatoes sides.
Yeah, I mean, the only thing that really varies with Flipside is how quickly they want to control middle. Sometimes it's really fast, sometimes it's slow. This time, they took their time, but Waylander is going to find Tabson full blind. But a kill comes in from Gabi. They're starting to get stalled out just a little bit, and the flank is coming in from Highway. Next, still alive in the site. He does go down, though, and now it's going to be a difficult 2v3 for Big.
Oh, Waylander nearly gets caught while reloading. He's still alive and does connect a headshot onto Key, which will cost him his life. But now it's got B's turn to come in. Trying his best to rinse repeat from Tabson. Can't get the clutch. Again, very close. Flipside only surviving with one player. And keep in mind that was 4 pistols and an SMG that took them to their limit. So Flipside aren't getting these rounds too cleanly.
No, that definitely cost them a lot more than they probably wanted. You're going to see Markolov even go into a MAC-10 to see if he can't bring some money back. He knows that Big are just going to be on pistols here to see if he can't farm some cash. So maybe you might see Markolov push the issue a bit more than he normally would from that squeaky door position because of it. And again, I keep noticing that Waylander's playing outside B, so this is definitely a change. Like, I guess Electronic, they're trying to get him more involved. He is kind of the key rifle on the team, so it's definitely something to keep an eye on. And it's good to see because I feel like Electronic is one of those like guys to keep an eye on. He really has added some new dynamics to this Flipside team, and we're going to see him and World Edit pair up at A, and World Edit already taking into this A bomb site. Smoke down, they'll be able to get in quite safely as it is just Big playing for the retake.
Really relying on those 2 Deagles now to go astronomically big. Electronic, the man you're expecting to pick up that kill 99 out of 100 times, does get bested courtesy of a USP. That's a little bit awkward. Still the firepower certainly in the favor of the terrorists, and they should be cleaning this one up. Big, think they can pick off some stragglers. Keeve has got himself the one kill. Next is not going to deliver on Forklift. And as you highlighted in the build-up, he's certainly one play that you're looking at. If Big want a chance of winning this finals, Next has got to show up. And he did, in fairness, on train yesterday, especially in the earlier stages. Obviously, it went on forever, seemingly. But he dropped 30 in lightning speed. So if right. he can have another one of those days, then Big do have a shot at this game.
Well, again, we talked about this in the pregame. Like, he's just the type of guy who can play very well, but sometimes he goes missing in the big games. And this obviously is a big game. You're in the grand finals on home soil. So far, he's done all right. He had that big 2 pistol kills to set Tabson up for the 1v2 clutch a little bit earlier. So he's definitely made his presence known there, particularly over on that A-bomb site. And now they're going to have full guns back on their hands as well. So we'll get some more opportunities to try to make some plays as you do see Gabi trying to Get some spam down through the smoke, just hold anyone off over at B. But once more, it is Flipside just taking it slow. They do put Blade over here to throw a smoke into CT spawn. Maybe try to make them bite on the fact that it could be a B execute coming in. See if he can't cheat some type of rotate. But Big have no reason to do so. They're not really feeling pressure anywhere else. So you're just going to see them kind of sit back and kind of a 2-1-2. You have Legia pressed up into middle, so he's being able to hear what's going on in mid-garage, and he even catches the boost from Waylander.
Frustrating round for Waylander. You saw earlier he was grimacing because he missed an easy frag on God B. Now he's gone down without too much more of a fight. Tabs in on Forklift, will get the drop onto Blade. And the second one, that flashbang though, the MVP, as far as Tabson's concerned, and Legia will turn the final screw. A Big will equalize this back up once again, but Waylander, you could really see the pain on his face. It was God B that charged through onto Checkered. He had him dead to rights and knocked him down to about 40 health in the end.
Yeah, well played by Tabson, but like you said, that flashbang that just came in was the hero there. Just good team play to set Tabson up for an easier frag. Taking a duel, I think it's a full blind player pretty much. And now Flipside, still piecing together a purchase though. You are gonna see three AKs out. Obviously utility is a bit limited, and a guy like Waylander, not having a rifle to entry frag with, is gonna limit him to an extent. As once more, Flipside just doing the basics, trying to get some position at B, make sure A main's clear, have some info on what's going on at Squeaky Door. Very set in their ways how Flipside approach this.
And sometimes that's to their detriment. Sometimes it seems like they do fail to adapt, especially against the top tier teams. And you see this a lot on their T sides, and it's very frustrating to watch sometimes. But in fairness to Flipside, they're a difficult team to beat as well. Big, this is going to be a huge test to see how the last couple of weeks has been going for them in terms of their strategic cohesion. The flashes into A main are going to yield a forklift push. In the smokes currently, Flipside are hiding, laid in wait. Leggy is going to get flashed down, but it's Nex and Tabs in that oh-so-powerful combination that once again comes to the forefront. The only assault rifle that Flipside possess has now been taken off the table alongside the rest of the team. Solid rounds. Now Big regain the lead.
Yeah, really well played. Tabs and Nex have been doing a really good job in tandem at that A bomb site. And I mean, that is two of their stronger riflers playing over on that side of the map. And so far, they're doing their job. They're taking care of business. They're making sure they get these crossfires set up and making it difficult on Flipside to find really any space to work with over in the A bomb site. As now Flipside will just have to work with pistols, no armor, no utilities. So, I mean, this really should just be a mop up round for Big. There really should be no chance for Flipside in a situation like this. They'll be looking into the next round as being their primary focus. As, I mean, this half is still quite close.
It sure is. You'd think it would be an easy round, but Waylander gets the opening pick with a pistol, gets the UMP, uses that against God B, and the bomb's still slap bang in the middle of the map. So Flipside are starting to move it over towards the B side, but there were options still available to them. But again, you fall into that similar conundrum for the terrorists. Sure, you have the player advantage, but you have no Kevlar, no nades, and you're up against M4s and Kevlar, but World, and it doesn't care about your Kevlar. He's gonna one-tap you nonetheless. Next does come back in, Incendiary being tossed onto the site. That is gonna start to get Markolov nice and crispy, but still gets the bomb planted. And now even more pressure being applied to Big, as they're gonna have to retake a man down.
Yeah, this is not going according to plan. They do have a kit in Nexus hands, though, so they do have a little bit more time to work with. They have a smoke to block off one player, but can they actually break in?
It's not looking good, is it? Nex goes and gets two, but therein lays the issue of being 2-1-3. You can get two frags, but surely the avenge kill comes through, and that's the round that is completely stolen from Big. That was pistols and nothing else.
Yeah, you hate to see teams lose those types of rounds. Those are the ones that you really should take care of. I mean, there was basically no investment here, no utility, no armor. They had that one deagle on Wayland, excuse me, on World Edit, and maybe a couple of other upgraded pistols. So yeah, you really shouldn't be letting those rounds slide through your fingers like that. That's maybe calm back to haunt them, as now look at what they have to work with. Key does still have the op in play. We haven't seen him really go off with it just yet on this CT side. So that's one of the guys that's been key for them throughout this tournament. So let's see if he can try to make a play. He could be the difference that Big will need in a round like this one, where they are very limited on their options. God B gonna play a little bit different position here. He's gonna be counter boosted inside the vent, so he might be able to come late mid and catch someone off guard. Meanwhile, Legge though has to worry about the fact that Electronic is right here. He's gonna get caught reloading, and that's a free pick for Electronic.
Gobby will trade back, but there's only so much you can do with the UMP when there's two terrorists breathing down your neck. Bomb retrieved. I think Electronic may have spotted Tabson. The call comes through, and World Edit will dispatch of him. So now it is all on the AWP and the M4. I do feel that Keev is kind of JW-esque in his AWPing, and I feel he's actually a stronger AWP on the T side than the CT side, when he can push the aggression, when he can dictate the play, be the playmaker. So I feel he does struggle a little bit on CT sides. And in fairness to him as well, his team have been getting battered, and there's only so much you can do in AWPs when you're 1-on-4, you've basically lost the round already, you're trying to retake on a site. It's asking a lot.
Yeah, I'm curious to see if they'll move him around a little bit with it. You know, maybe just get him more involved. Maybe push him squeaky. You know, you can PK main with a pop flash. You can even see him take a pick in the B lobby. Just try to put him in some different positions and see if he can't find something. I think that's how you get someone like him involved. I think you comparing on the JW is a pretty fair comparison. I think that does make a lot of sense. He's the, kind of that wild card type of factor. Very quick aim. But Flipside's really starting to piece something together here on this half. That is for sure. I mean, obviously, it certainly helped that they won a round with just pistols, but they're also taking care of business on rounds like this when they've really only made maybe one big mistake, and then they lost, like, one clutch round, which isn't necessarily a problem. So they've definitely been doing a good job here on the T side.
And Keith's whole performance on train on the T side was very reminiscent to me of someone like JW. He was so aggressive. He's almost more aggressive than an entry fragger would be with the AK through the smoke. Obviously, we're just talking over this round somewhat as it is. Going to be pistols and not much chance for Vig. Flipside will not give them any leeway whatsoever. They are going for the jugular, ruthless aggression. Bomb planted on B in the next few moments by Markolov. And just a CZ for God B, so maybe looking for an exit if they can. But Flipside will take a two-round lead.
Yeah, I mean, you're seeing some of the key players for Flipside performing really well. Waylander, Electronic, you know, World Edit, all these guys, the main firing force of Flipside are currently doing their jobs quite well. And Big having a tough time here again. Someone like Keeve has a little bit of a tougher time, and then Gabi and Legia haven't really been in the game too much just yet, but they are going to have a full buy in the next round, and again, this is maybe where you can see Keeve let loose a little bit more. Maybe try to set him up to make a play, as he's not like he has like a bad negative KD ratio or something too poorly. It's just you haven't like noticed him as much as you normally would, and in this round, he unfortunately can't afford it now. He's just going to have an ump. But I'm curious to see if maybe they try to do something different, because Big has been fairly passive on most rounds, and this is certainly a map that plays to being able to be aggressive. You can get away with more, like peak flashing A main or peak flashing B lobby, pushing a squeaky door. There's a lot of options, so it'd be nice to see some of that. And this is the other option, the potential counter boost. There is actually no one here, though, to boost them up, so he's just actually looking to maybe catch someone off guard coming out middle.
Yeah, and God B has played fairly aggressive in mid quite a few times already, so I do worry a little bit for Legia here if he could get end up getting flashed and basically just fragged. Tabson does have his back in vents, so that's going to give him an extra blanket of security. But Gobby's pushed this with a UMP two or three times now in the kind of half-buy eco scenarios. And I feel like Waylander and Blades, they're wise to this. They know what's coming up against them. They do have this set up for an A execute in the next few moments. Tabson's going to go for that boost, and he's going to see the bomb very shortly alongside World Edit. Just get the hell out of there. There are multiple players tracking you down, Tabson. But he's going to be using the boost to actually hide behind. It's going to be his sanctuary for the next few moments. This is going to apply the pressure, and Markolov actually lands a double headshot. Tabson and Legia winding back the years. Down to 17, but those two kills could be huge for Flipside.
That gets him right back into the round. That was massive for Markolov. Taz was doing such a great job on the counter boost, making plays, not overextending. After he got the first pick, he was being patient, but Markolov chased after him and brought him down, gets two kills, and now Flipside, they have an end into this round. Can Keev and company hold off this execute? It's going to be the big question. Smokes and flashes coming in, and here comes Flipside.
Keeves UMP could go to town as the flash lands in the eyes of Electronic. 10 seconds get on the site. Nexus having none of it with his double. Big hold on. Just about. It was looking poor when Markolov landed his double on boost. But the flashes again come to the rescue. And that's another thing that really hurts Flipside from time to time. They are very slow and sometimes too late to execute on sites. And that's where one flash can ruin your day.
Yeah, we're just taking a look at the replay here of Markolov. That was just nasty being able to transfer onto Legia like that. But it was Nex who was the hero here over on the A-bomb. That's going to make it 7-6, but Big still struggling economically. You can see an up still had to come into play here. Again, Leggy and Tabs, they're going to have this aggressive middle set up. They're not going for the counter boost this time, but they're still going to have a bit of a bait and switch going on in Keeve. He's going to play the edge of a smoke, so here he is. He's trying to create a play, doing something a little bit different. Waylander, so far, not showing anything to him. He just holds out in the corner, so it's going to be a bit of a stalemate as Keeve will just back off into the A site. Meanwhile, World Edit does have his op trained over here towards Highway, but he will be smoked out. And so, again, typical Flipside, typical slow start to the round. We just have to kind of wait and see what Flipside wants to transfer into. But Tabson will actually go for the counter boost again. Okay, comes a little bit later this time, so maybe the off timing could catch Flipside off guard.
Maybe just playing the double mind games as well. He has spotted. Oh, Markloff and Tabson's not going to get it. Did knock him down to 32, but that's not good enough. Maybe assuming that Flipside would be like, oh, they can't go for the boost again. Surely not. And it nearly worked out, but unfortunately, the whiff was real. Two-player deficit. Well, then it is low, but he does have the up in his hands. Time is starting to tick in favor of Big. Keeve on forklift again. This time he has an M4 as opposed to the UMP, and Blade will headshot him out of the equation. God be UMP, full utility, just going to be trying to save.
Yeah, this time around, the aggression at middle from Big does not pan out. Tabson really missed a huge opportunity there. He's definitely not going to be happy about that one, I'm sure. And I mean, it's just too early of picks from Flipside. I think they got a 5v3 just very quickly there. So it's able to roll that advantage into a round win, no problem. So it will be 8-6 going into the last round of the half. It's been a tight race thus far, but Flipside are starting to get a little bit of an edge here. And I believe the money is still quite low for the CT side. So obviously they'll buy all that they can in this next round, but it won't be a whole lot. Gabi being able to upgrade to an AK from an up certainly helps a little bit. But you can tell that Flipside are not looking to let him have this one. They're going to chase him down. Electronic will take him out. And so you're looking at a round where the CT side is going to be struggling to make really any purchases.
Understandable as well why he would go for that peek. Knowing he's in checkered, his position was compromised. Not out of the ordinary to see maybe a Molly or a HE just fly underneath his feet, force him out into the open anyway. But you can see the effect that that has on Big in the last round of this half. That is going to be just pistols and Kevlar. 9-6 wouldn't be the end of the world. I still feel Big are going to probably have a better T half than their CT half. Flipside almost susceptible on their CT side on cash, I feel.
Yeah, this is a map that can kind of go either way for me, to be honest. I mean, I think it's a little bit more T-sided than people give it credit for. When you look at the stats, even in top pro tournaments, it seems like the T-side has been slightly favored recently. But, I mean, so with that said, I think Big having six rounds T-side, that's not too shabby. I mean, I'm sure they wanted more out of it, and there's still maybe a chance to put this one through, as Nex is playing a little bit of an uncanny position. Don't really see that too often, so maybe he could get the drop on someone. As it certainly is, Flipside looking to hit this A-bomb site as you see them gathering up here. We do have a rotate coming in from Keeve as well. What can Nex do? Not going to find anything. Markloff sniffs him out, but Tabson's still around here, dancing around the smoke, trying to get nifty here. Does get around, takes so much damage in the world that it will put him down. And this round is in the books for the most part.
As is this half, it would seem. Again, yeah, six rounds I don't think is too bad, but Flipside putting up 9. On the first half, one hell of a way to start off the grand finals. Had some pretty big performances from the likes of Markloff on your screen right now. Keeve hasn't really had the same impact that we expected, but I think T-side could very well come down to him. Meanwhile, Tabson and Nex both landed, I think it was about 13 kills each, although Tabson did have that that fairly nasty to look at whiff.
Right. Yeah, I mean, this is a map that I think Tabson's actually really strong on the T side. When I was watching him play on Energy, he was kind of one of those guys who could be a playmaker from Squeaky Door. Not at the same level as like a Shox or a Nico, sure, but he's the guy that can kind of play those peripherals, but also can be used as kind of an entry fragger, a second entry frag type player. And so he's a guy that feels really comfortable playing this map with a rifle in his hands. And so if Tabson can work things out, he can definitely give Big some chances here. You did mention Keeve, obviously, with the op in a situation where he can be a bit more active and try to create plays a bit better than on the CT side, where he's kind of just responding to what he sees. I think that could play into Big's hand as well. I mean, don't forget that throughout this tournament, we did see Cash have a really big victory on Rogue. And again, I think historically, it's just been a map that Gabi is like to call on. So they're definitely not out of this yet. But I mean, let's not forget that Flipside put together quite a good T-side. I mean, 9 rounds, really well done. They played their style they normally play. They used it to good effect. They won a couple of key rounds. And despite Big having like a hot start, they recovered well.
Yeah, you can't argue with 9 rounds on the T side. Of paramount importance to Big, they do pick up this pistol. They've shown great tenacity throughout this tournament. Seen multiple match points for Vega last night. Markolov not able to connect. Gonna be using the boxes for safety for the time being. The bomb is over on the A side as Waylander puts the first bullet down range and it goes right between Godby's eyes. That's gonna give the green light for the A hit. They're not gonna be able to sell this fake for too much longer. Electronic is gonna take down Tabson though. So even though the bomb's been planted, Flipside have the advantage. Kit for blades, a few nades as well to play with. And Big, just hoping, praying that somebody from Flipside walks around the corner and gets their head taken from them. Next, gonna be coming in with the Glock. Tabson is no longer a part of this round either with his pistol prowess. So Flipside are gonna get the round. It's a bomb plant. We could very well see the early AK buy in. But that is certainly a huge lifeline that has been lost now for Big.
I mean, they were playing a retake A setup, and it stinks that before the execute even comes in, they already have 2 kills. I mean, at the point, you're just climbing a massive uphill battle, and there's really no coming back from that. Just some really sick shots from some of those guys on Flipside there at the early part of the round. And like you noted, with that first round bomb plant, they'll have the option to buy in the next round, and you can see they're going to take full advantage of that. In this round, just a few pistols. Do have 3 smokes, so maybe just looking to see if they can't smoke out the A bomb site, get a plant in there somehow. But they're definitely focused up on that next round. That's going to be the key one to see how the second half is going to play out.
Big throwing in pretty much all of their utility. Full on engage. Onto the A site is imminent. Electronic with the UMP lands 2 headshots, not able to scurry away. Back to the site and reload and come back stronger. The bomb is gonna get planted in amongst the smoke. And now the P250 from Nex is almost a perfect circle spray around Blade. Unfortunate for Big, but they have pretty much set out on the quest of planting the bomb. And that is gonna be a success. This is gonna bolster their buy into the next round, which we'll see AKs. But it has to start right here, right now. If the comeback is gonna come, better sooner rather than later.
And let's not forget how important it is for them to win this map, because when you think about the rest of the maps we're gonna see in the pool, Flipside can be the favorite team in those situations. I mean, they certainly seem to be the more comfortable team on train. They did beat Big on Overpass in day one, and those are the next 2 maps on the slide. So, I mean, if you're Big, you feel like we need to win this one. This is our pick. This is our best chance to you know, get maps in this series. So definitely don't want to see them let this one slide. Meanwhile, though, Flipside, they're feeling good about this. If they can take this away from Big, that's going to set them up well to take the trophy. So we are going to see our first gun round. Electronic looking to push the issue here in A main as he's going to be playing over the top of the smoke. Keys so far not giving him anything to shoot at, but Gabi has gotten a pick on the other side of the map on the Waylander.
That timing though, as soon as Electronic moves down, Keeve jumps across. Get wrecked. Keeve can't necessarily see where Electronic went. Still thinks he may be in the smoke somewhere. Of course, we have the benefit of knowing that's not the case, but Godby elsewhere on the map did get the first kill onto Waylander. So Big have something to work with here in round 18.
Yeah, him and Nex paired up over on the B side, put some pressure over there and took down Waylander. And you actually see that flip side of rotated pretty heavy towards B, so maybe even thinking about pushing out to B lobby. World at it beginning to fall off, but Flipside really looking to see if they can't find a pick here, but Nex is not going to give it to him. He's just hiding out in Sunroom. In the meantime, you do see Big shifting all their players over towards this B side of the map. So just as soon as World at it begins to fade back over to the A side of the map, now Big wanted to strike. They also have presence at middle as well, so this could get really dicey for Flipside as they don't even have a player on the site, and even Blade has begun to back off now because he knows that mid is a gap in the defense he needs to keep an eye on. So, I mean, Godby has read this round well. He's setting us up team for success as this execute is rolling in.
Markolov plays a pivotal role here, especially if he doesn't get smoked out, which wouldn't make a lot of sense because there's still 3 smokes in the hands of Big. They're going to allow Markolov to tee off. What's happening here, Big? Somebody get rid of Heaven. You're giving away 3 kills at this stage. They're still going to be able to force the site and get the plant down. But how instrumental could that free frag end up being? Especially as it was Nex, one of the guys you're looking to fend off this retake. They're all clumped together on the CT side. No one's gonna be flanking from either vents or behind Big. Like he's gonna use that smoke to his advantage for the time being. Just hiding in here. The flashes are connecting with the spray on the Galil is good for 1 kill. And that's going to force back Electronic and Blade, and Big are going to get themselves on the board. But I was very worried there for a second that Markolov was going to make them pay for that lack of utility.
Yeah, Gabi really read that round well, I feel like. I mean, it started out with him and Nex being able to pair up to get a pick on the B bomb site, so you get a pretty quick 5-on-4. And if you're working a default from a 5-on-4, you know it's going to be so difficult for the CTs to rotate the way that they want to. They always have to kind of worry about where the gap, the defense is going to be. How can I cover that? Do I need to gamble and kind of leave something open and focus somewhere else? And I think that you just saw them work through that very well. And to get into B, yeah, they did have some issues there for a moment. It did start to look a little bit shaky, but they get the job done nonetheless. And so now it is going to be 7-11 and flip side on a very low buy here. Just a couple of those M4s that were saved and a few pistols. So this is definitely giving Big a chance to start getting to the heels of flip side and getting towards that tie situation. As we see Big definitely looking to firmly commit to this B bomb site. Gabi setting up smokes for perhaps headshot angle and CT spawn. They have some mollies as well to cover the bomb site. So it's going to be just a heavy blitz of an execute with full utility.
And amongst all the chaos, though, we'll see Markolov with his P250 close range dispatch of Legia. No more kills will be forthcoming. Waylander on an island of clarity. Two smokes will be separating him and the terrorists for the time being. Whereas last time there's a clump of CT retake aggression, this time more checkered and vent control being established by Flipside. Blade with his saved M4A4 is going to put it to use on Tabson. Nex spots a player in heaven. They know that Blade is in vents. So two of the remaining three players, their positions are known. Electronic's now going to force his way through into the site. Big, you can't afford to lose this round. This would be so catastrophic. And Electronic and Blade will go for the spray. Oh, Big, how do you lose that? You're just against two assault rifles to start off with.
Those are the kinds of rounds that get to you, I feel like. I mean, you did such a great job winning your first big gun round of the half, and you're starting to set yourself up for the comeback, and then you have a round like this one just go awry. You know, it was one of those rounds where, again, you noted it, very limited firepower to work with, but you see Electronic and Blade coming together in a big way to retake that B bomb site. And again, we talked about how key of a player Electronic can be. You know, we're 19 rounds into the game, and the guy has 22 kills, so he's definitely doing exactly what you'd expect of him. That's certainly good news for Flipside. As now Big, they're on the back foot. They're the ones with just pistols to work with. They have a little bit of armor spread out, but only that one flashbang on Nex, who's gonna be over towards A main. So you can maybe see him try to flash players out of squeaky door, see if they can't just close the range with these pistols, maybe overwhelm quad, try to get into the slot and get the bomb plant, but that's about the best they could hope for. And in reality, they may not even be able to do that with Electronic in such a forward position with the AK.
Does get dinked through the smoke and nearly finished off onto 9, and there's Tabson with the headshot. Blade still occupying quads. That incendiary is pretty massive, actually. It stops the plant from being put down anytime soon. And forces got beat in. He just face plants against the wall. It's all next. There's one tap with the Tech 9. Two players remain, 50 seconds in which to try and salvage this round. 13-7, though, will be the score.
Yeah, so Flipside are starting to extend that lead now. And Big are beginning to run out of rounds where they're going to have comfortable buys. You know, it's starting to get to that point where you're going to be stuck in situations where you're going to have to start force buying. You're not really going to be able to get everything you want. So this is actually probably one of the last, like, real healthy buys where they'll have full utility and have an op in Keeve's hands. And again, Keeve hasn't been as active on the scoreboard as we're used to seeing. And this is, I think, one of the only rounds we've actually seen him have an op on the T side. This is going to be his first opportunity to see if he can't create a play for his team. As you see, he is holding A main right now, just looking for aggression, which, to be fair, we have seen Electronic do just that, and there he is again. Electronic has been an absolute nuisance for Big in this map.
I mean, Keeve just got out-Keeved there. That is a peak you don't really expect. Completely caught him off guard. And one of the guys you're looking to really get the opening picks and the impact frags dead and buried in the opening parts of the round.
And luckily, Tabson's still on the map. He's the other big guy on cash for me for this team that can maybe create a play. He has been able to push up towards white box, but there's definitely the man advantage for Flipside. World Edit is waiting for this with that op over in the A bomb site. So Big do get mid control at the very least, but they do have a numbers disadvantage. They're going to get together, though, and split this B bomb site. So not a bad idea. Just going to try to play the numbers game on the B site and see if they can't get past Markolov and Waylander, but there's definitely some counter nades to be had here. Markolov with the incendiary can definitely limit some of these options on the pushes. Counter smoke comes in as well on the lobby, and this is a cheeky position for Markolov.
Somewhat given away by the spray. It doesn't matter though. Waylander chimes in with two. Legia picks up the AWP. Next gets two of his own. Maybe this is where it becomes the next shot. Or perhaps not. Waylander will finalize his 4K and take Flipside one step closer. Now 14-7. This gap may be a bridge too far on a map that I feel Big may very well have fancied themselves to pick up.
This was their strongest chance to get a map in this series. And when I predicted Big to win, I accounted for the fact that they must win this map. And so now it's really starting to spiral out of control for them. I mean, Flipside have been putting together an excellent game. Their T-side, we talked about it. They stuck to their normal game plan of playing very default, very methodical. They read rounds well. They got nine. Even after losing pistol, they were able to like get nine rounds. So that was like a really big half. And now we're in the second half and their CT side has been up to the task. You know, that while we have seen Gabi read rounds pretty well and give his team situations where they're playing numbers advantages, particularly how he's been able to kind of get a pick and then work into these B executes where he knows that he's gonna have the jump on the opponent because he has more numbers to work with. But they're not necessarily getting the frags they need. I mean, you're seeing guys step up on Flipside and hold their spots. Like, you've seen Electronic, particularly on the A-bomb side. He's definitely been up to the task. And now you got Waylander, who's up to 20 kills in his own right, playing over on the B-side. And he's starting to kind of put a stop to some of these pushes you're seeing. So when I'm God B and I know that I'm low on money, I don't know if I'm going to be able to get Kiev and Op again. This is where your options become a little bit more limited. And in this round, you can see that they're going to buy up all that they can. I mean, why not? You know that if you can't do this, Flipside are going to be on map point. So this is your chance to try to handle things in regulation. And so they're going to try to put all their chips in this particular basket. And that's going to be the B bomb site where they're going to just dump this utility in and just hope that they can force their way through.
I expect to see Molotovs at the back of the site towards headshot and on the B boxes with a whole bunch of flashes. Although we see Markolov did just flash himself. It's not going to cost him too much of the time being. In fact, yes, it will. Next comes through with two kills. Markolov and Waylander both will be put 6 foot under. And this is one of the best opportunities that Big have had. Still, though, with two incendiaries, one of which has just been thrown out and could very well claim the kill onto Nex. In actual fact, Nex ends up killing himself. I don't quite know what happened there. Maybe a replay will help us out. Regardless, though, this does mean that Flipside have a bit of a better chance at getting this retake into effect. Blade desperately just trying to land a shot round the corner, but he's by and large blinded. Electronic now, who's been the standout player for Flipside today, is going to go down. And finally, Big will pick up their second round on T side. They still trail 14-8.
Indeed, the force buy comes through, and it's not at a better moment, right? They're running out of time. They're running out of rounds. And this is going to be next. Yeah, what did happen here?
He also
threw his own molly, and then he got trapped between two mollies and had to run into his own. Ouch.
Just molly things.
He won the round, though, so it's okay.
I mean, it's either run into his own molly or die to the hands of whoever. I think it may have been Blade that thrown it out from heaven. He was in a bit of a rough spot and he's very low on health. But that instantly forces Flipside into just pistols. They have a bit of Kevlar to play with. It's getting a bit too hot for comfort for Electronic. But Wilded and Blade both coming with pistol kills out of nowhere. And Wilded continues to be a boss with the Deagle. Another tap onto God B this time around. Although it was Blade that did the bulk of the damage. And now next. Big desperately needs you to deliver. Needs to pick that bomb up, has done just that. Still unsure as to where the second player is and gets picked off from behind by Waylander. And this has just been...
And the hammer comes down. I mean, so now your economy's been reset and now you have to try to march seven rounds in a row to get this into overtime. I mean, World Edit, we've been singing the tune of Waylander and Electronic throughout this game being Big. I mean, World Edit has been a little bit more quiet, but that was a big round with the Deagle. Just absolutely surgical work there with that to get those headshots. And I mean, Big, you can't lose rounds like that. There's a few force buys that Big have lost this game, just like they used a force buy to get kind of maybe try to give them a chance to get back into the game in the previous round. Now it's piled against them and this is not looking good. And now that spot could be the checkmate. Are they really gonna check that? Especially since they did it the way that can't be heard from Squeaky Door. So they may not even have like the information that he's up there.
And that last round really was just the reoccurrence of what we've seen time and time again so far in Cash. Big momentum-based team, unable to get momentum. We've seen them get around here, around there, nothing consecutive on their T side. And a 9-6 deficit at halftime. Godby and Tabson, the only two assault rifles in play for the time being. Four big, one of which Godby is trying to make his presence felt in mid. The rest of his team are wrapping their way onto the A side.
A little bit surprised not to see an AK in Nex's hands or something. I mean, he's kind of your big guy to try to create something, but we'll see how this plays out. Again, will they really check Electronic's spot? It's going to be the first time it's used the whole game, and they're not going to do so. And so Electronic can deliver a couple of maybe finishing blows here, but Godby going to try to bring it back, and he gets it into a 2v2. There's some time as well to go ahead and get that bomb planted. They'll just have to see if they can't fend off this retake from Waylander and Marklaw. They both have kits. They have a smoke and a flash. They don't really have an incendiary to get Godby out of this quad position, so that's going to be the big task. And now Leggy is stuck playing close range to the op inside the site. That could be a little bit tricky, but he does have a good angle here.
It could very much get the kill onto Marklaw, who wouldn't be expecting, but Leggy has missed his chance. And herein lays the issue with being in this situation. If you miss that shot, you are basically stuck there. And Godby can't really dig him out of this one. The headshot comes through for Godby. Can he get the clutch? It will be a 3K on top of everything else, and Godby connects. He's had a great tournament, in fairness. He's not one of the first names that comes to mind when we talk about big star players, but he's been pulling his weight and then some.
Indeed, that is the play that keeps them alive. I mean, it's not the big play that wins them the game, but at least it gives them a few more rounds to try to see if they can't get the job done. But remember, they did something similar, and then they wound up losing a force buy to a flip side team that had even less than what they have to work with now, so they're certainly not out of the woods yet. I try my best not to be the pessimist, but you have to be realistic here. Big haven't really been able to find their footing on this T side. They've only had a few rounds here and there, and this time Keith denies Electronic. That's the revenge. He gets the redemption.
Nice shot, but just down to two health. This is where the CZ and P250 become that much more terrifying a prospect. Godby narrowly missing out on a kill. Keith needs to be careful. He just boosted up his teammate. Tabson comes in with two headshots in the meanwhile elsewhere. And now close range. Godby could very well pick up a kill onto his opposite number of blades. In-game leader on in-game leader. Waylander is good for one. Tabson takes him out, and Godby's starting to get pumped now.
And the crowd is starting to finally have a little bit of something to cheer about, because Big are starting to try to make this movement towards putting this into overtime. They're still certainly quite a few steps away from doing so, but it's becoming a little bit more realistic as each round passes, because Flipside are starting to run out of money, and they're in that situation now. They're going to be buy saving almost the rest of this half, really. And so that means that Big only really needs to win just, you know, two or three more real gun rounds to actually put this in. They're going to find rounds like this one a couple of more times where they're not going to have to fight against much. And next, though, able to clear out with Tabson over here at B, so the aggression so far being picked up, but this round is still a little bit dangerous because Tabson and Godby are very low on HP, but Keeve is able to find Electronic, and so Flipside are running out of players at this point.
And that was a scrappy confrontation, wasn't it? Tabson missing the bulk of his mag. But as a Flipside just have pistols, doesn't get punished. 15-10. Looking like Big will take this round. But as you mentioned earlier, which is a fair point, Big haven't really had a lot of success when it comes to consecutive rounds. So this is a huge ask to get the next five, well, the next four in a row after this, of course, assuming they pick up this round. I can't see why they wouldn't.
It hasn't really necessarily been tactical reasons that they haven't been able to find a bunch of rounds. Like I said, I think Gabi's done pretty well leading. It's just been they've been getting out fried. They're losing force buys that they can't be losing to. And hopefully they'll be able to avoid that going forward, as we are seeing Leggia put some of the final touches on this round, as well, that it is going to be disposed of. And so now it's just Blade left. Just the USP. This round should be all but over, and there it is. So another round on the board for Big, just four away now from forcing an overtime, and we're certainly no strangers to overtime in this tournament. We had one last night go four. Big won that, of course, against Vega Squadron to even put themselves in the semifinals today, so they're no strangers themselves.
Yeah, and that surely factors in as well. These guys played a lot of CS yesterday. They've already played a match today. So certainly feel like they should be warm at this stage. Flipside are already coming through with a full buy from us in the hands of Blade. So no AWP at their disposal. K Keeves moved on to 12 kills, hasn't had the same impact though. He has been getting a couple kills in the last few rounds, so maybe that's a statement of things to come. Utility being expended on both sides, and they're going to decide to push the button right now and go straight in. Wayland's going to get two kills from the same position and manage to scamper away with his life. Electronic puts down Tabson, and this could be the beginning of the end. As Big, I mean, they are under so much pressure now. It's a 2v5. There's the first kill for Keeve. He's going to get flanked and needs to be oh so careful. Godby, in the meanwhile, turns his back onto Electronic, maybe assuming the flash was coming in. That cost him his life. Keeve misses out, and Big will concede map number one, a map that they simply had to win.
Yeah, again, you never really saw Keeve get wrong with that op. And to be fair, the way that they were playing there towards the end, they were really just relying on some execute to try to break through it, so the op couldn't really have as much of a presence as it normally would. And they got burned on that B-bomb side several times. Again, you gotta credit the flip side, the way they played their CT side. I mean, they take cash away from Big, and now,